Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 1.9 that is taken from chapter number 1, Stress, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbler, 9th edition. And the topic which we are covering is average shear stress. So statement is determine the average shear stress in 20 millimeter diameter pin at A and 30 millimeter diameter pin at B that support the beam in figure 1-21A. So you can see this is the beam that is supported by pin support at point A, and at point B we have a rope that is connected at this point, pin support at C. So there is a point load of 30 kilonewton. So you have to determine the average shear stress at A and B. So this is point A and this is point B. So what we will do is that we will find this average shear stress. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that if you remove this pin support at point A, so what we will do is we will draw the free body diagram of this beam AB. So let this is beam AB, this is your point A. So when you have removed this pin support at point A, so you will be having a vertical reaction force at this point A, which is equal to AY, and similarly you have a horizontal reaction force which will be equal to AX. Okay, now you can see there is a wire or rope BC, which due to this load there will be a tensile load in this wire BC. As a result, this wire BC exert force on this beam in this direction. Clear? So this will be, I will write, this is point B where you have a load of BC, and this BC is equal to FBC. And you can see the ratios are given. This is vertical is 4, this is 3, 4, 3 and 5. And there is a point load of 30 kilonewton at a distance of 2 meter from point A. So this is 30 kilonewton, and this distance from point A is 2 meter. And the remaining distance you can see that is 4 meter. So this distance from 30 kilonewton load till point B, this is 4 meter length. Now we'll find this AX, AY and FBC by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all movements about point A is equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise movement as positive. So about this point A, the first movement that is produced by this 30 kilonewton load and the perpendicular distance is 2 meter, and this is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So I can write it minus 30 multiplied by 2. Now you can see that this FBC will have two components. One will be along X component, so this will be FBC X component, and one will be along Y direction, and this will be FBC Y component. So this FBC X component is not producing any movement because it is passing through point A, so only the vertical component FBC Y is producing movement, and perpendicular distance is this 6, and this is producing clockwise movement, counterclockwise movement, so it will be positive. So I can write plus FBC Y component multiplied by 6 is equal to 0. So again you can see here that if you take, if this, let this is theta, so if you take sine of theta, so sine of theta will be equal to sine of theta will be equal to this vertical component, which is this one, which will be this one, divided by this FBC. So I can write it FBC Y component divided by FBC. Clear? And from this right angle triangle, you can see sine of theta will be equal to 4 over 5. So I can write sine theta is equal to 4 by 5 is equal to FBC Y divided by FBC. So what does it means? It means that FBC Y component is equal to 4 over 5 times FBC. So I can replace it minus 30 into 2 plus FBCY is 4 over 5. FBC and FBC is not known. Clear? We are finding it multiply by 6 is equal to 0. Okay. So from here we will get 24 FBC over 5 is equal to 60. So FBC will be equal to, when you calculate it, will be 12.5 kilonewton. Now you have this FBC, so you can find this AX and AY by using equation of equilibrium. So that will be sum of all forces along X direction must be equal to zero and force toward right hand side is taken as positive. So you can see that FBCX is acting in horizontal and AX is also acting in horizontal. Since AX is opposite, so I can write minus AX plus FBC X component is equal to zero. So FBC X component will be equal to AX. Now what does FBCX, so if you take cos of theta, so cos of theta is equal to FBC X component divided by FBC. And also from this right angle triangle, cos of theta will be 3 divided by 5. So I can write it FBC X component will be equal to 3 over 5 times FBC. And you can put it AX will be equal to FBC. FBC is 12.5. So 12.5 multiplied by 3 over 5. So when you calculate it, you will get AX. AX comes out to be 7.50 kilonewton. Now the last unknown is AY. So that can be obtained by using the third equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along Y direction must be equal to 0. And upward force is taken as positive. So you can see one force is AY, the second one is minus 30 plus this component FBCY. Their sum must be equal to 0. So I can write it AY minus 30 plus 12.5 kilonewton multiplied by 4 over 5 is equal to 0. So when you solve this, you will get this AY comes out to be 20 kilonewton. From this, we can say that AX is this one and AY is this one. Clear? So what if I draw the resultant of this? So AX is in this direction and AY is in this direction. So resultant will be in this direction. Clear? So this beam, this spin is exerting, this beam is exerting a load of, resultant load of A on this pin in this direction. So I can find that load by using Pythagoras theorem. So what I say is that resultant force acting on pin A is A, and that will be equal to AX square plus AY square under the root. So just plug in the value 7.50 whole square plus 20 whole square under the root. So when you solve this, you will get this this reaction force at point A comes out to be 21.36 kilonewton load. Okay. Now we will conclude that you can see that this load A is equal to 21.36 beam exerting on this pin at A. As a result, force exerted on this pin will be in this direction. Let me tell you again, these are the load that is exerted by pin on this beam. Okay, so its resultant will be like this. You can see this is one, this is other, this. So resultant force on the pin is this one. Clear? And these are the forces applied by a pin on this beam, and their resultant is in this direction. As a result, the load acting on pin will be in this direction. You can see this load is downward, which is causing force to act on pin in this direction. So I can just represent that this is your pin A. This was your pin A, and you can see your load is acting in this direction, and this load is A. Or you can also say that force at pin A is equal to 21.36 kilonewton. And from this diagram, you can see this pin is causing double shear. Clear? So what I can write is that you have a shear force on this face, which is equal to VA, and there is a shear force in this face also, on this face. This is VA. Clear? So how we'll find this VA? So by using equation of equilibrium, I will write it over here that this FA, if this sum of all forces is equal to zero and force in this direction is taken as positive, so FA minus 2 times VA is equal to zero. So 21.36 minus 2VA is equal to zero. So it means that VA is equal to how much? It will be 10.68 kilonewton. Okay. Once you have find this shear force at point A, and again we can see that this is rope exerting force on this P in this direction, clear, on this beam. As a result, this rope exert force on pin in this direction, and you can see this is a single shear. So I can represent, and this force will be FBC. So force acting on this pin will be in this direction, clear, and this is FB, and FB is equal to FBC, that is equal to 12.5 kilonewton. And as there is only single shear, so what does it mean? It means that only this face will experience shear force, which is VB. So VB will be equal to FB, and that will be equal to 12.5 kilonewton. Now we'll move toward the average shear stress at point A. So we can write average shear stress at point A is equal to shear stress at point A divided by shearing area. So you can see diameter of this pin is given, which is 20 millimeter. So I can write it 10.68 into 10 to the power 3 will convert it into newton divided by area. So area is pi by 4, diameter is 20 millimeter, which is 0.02 meter, and it's square. So when you solve it, you will get 34 megapascals. So average shear stress at point A comes out to be 34 megapascals. Now what will be the average shear stress at point B? That will be equal to VB divided by area at B, shear area at B. So VB is 12.5, so 12.5 into 10 to the power 3 divided by area. So pin B has an area of 30 millimeter. So sharing area will be this one, and this will be equal to pi by 4 d square, and d is 0.03. And at the end, when you solve this, you will get average shear stress at point B comes out to be 17.7 megapascal. And these are the answers of our this question. And that was all about this example 1.9. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.